Hello, dear friends. So today it's class number 2 in the special course, ongoing course called Living Light Consciousness. Now, first of all, if you don't recognize me yet, my name is Moshe Malin. I'm learning Kabbalah and also teaching Kabbalah for the last 25 years. And the teachings, these specific teachings in this course, it's basically based on the writings of a great Kabbalist, Rabbi Ashlag. And the purpose of this course is basically to help us to understand what's the message of life. What's the whole purpose of life? What we actually doing here? Every one of us, all humanity, what we're supposed to achieve? What is our goal? Kabbalah actually talks about the most important question of life. Who are we? What's supposed to be, you know, like, what's our purpose? Where are we going? Where are we heading? Once we'll understand better the game of life, the purpose of the game of life, and the rules of the game of life, we will be able to enjoy more. Because if you play a game and you understand what's the rules, you can enjoy from that game. You can also learn how to, on the way to, you know, to achieve a lot of more knowledge and experience, and eventually to be successful, eventually to win the game of life. And these great teachings, Kabbalah, help us to become better people, to understand how to connect with the endless love that the Creator wants to share with every one of us, and to open ourselves. The word Kabbalah, it actually means to receive, to learn how to receive all the blessings that God wants to give us, meant to be ours. So last time, and again, as I said, the teachings of this specific course is based on the writings of Rabbi Ashlag. We started from a great article, it was written by Rabbi Ashlag last century, and we already learned and read verse 1 and 2, and we talked last time, if you remember, and if you don't remember, you're always welcome to listen again. It's really important. We talked about that Rabbi Akiva, great sage in the name of Rabbi Akiva, said that the entire message of God in the Torah, because the Torah, the Bible, the five books of Moses, it's the gift of God to humanity. And a great Kabbalist in the name of Rabbi Akiva is asking the question, or is actually saying, what's the whole message of the Torah? What's bottom line? There's so many stories in the Torah about Moses, about the Israelites, about Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, so many stories. What's the bottom line? What's the message of God? And Rabbi Akiva actually is saying, if you remember last time that we learned, on verse number 1, he said, love the fellow man. The whole purpose of life, what we came to learn in this world, is how to love. And the whole Torah is coaching us the same way that a person is going to a gym to get exercise, to be in fit, and to, you know, to strengthen their muscles, their heart, their lungs. Also, we need to exercise our consciousness. And what does it mean to exercise our consciousness? It means constantly, Rabbi Akiva says, constantly to focus our energy, our life, toward the direction of how to love, to learn how to love, to exercise ourselves how to love. But to really understand how to love, it's a whole journey of life. Even though the word love is a beautiful word, and, you know, we can just say the word, I believe in love and everything, but does it mean that I really exercise love? That I really know how to practice love every moment of my life? The knowledge of Kabbalah, so it will teach us and help us to exercise constantly how to love. And that's why Rabbi Akiva says that the entire message of God, the entire message of the Torah and all the precepts of the Torah is to teach us and to educate us and to help us to exercise learning how to love. That's what we learn, the same thing. Someone came to him and asked him, teach me the entire Torah as I'm standing on one leg. Tell me in one sentence, what's the whole message of the Torah? And we learned last time, if you remember, that the answer was, if there's something that the other person is doing that you don't like, that you really kind of hate that that person is doing it, make sure that you won't do it, what you don't like that the other person is doing. And we said and we spoke and we learned that the deeper message here is that if something upsets you about the behavior of the other person, it means that it's a gift for you. That person or that behavior was sent by the Creator to help you, because the fact that it's annoying you, it's making you angry, it's causing you to hate that behavior, it's if you're willing to open yourself, you actually realize that it's not a coincidence, that that person is a messenger for you, that person is a mirror for you to help you to see that the same way that you can take the fact that the other person is ignorant, is selfish, is only thinking about himself, it's an indication for you to see where you, maybe you in your life, in maybe not exactly in the same way that that person behaved, but maybe in a different aspect, in a different way, you behave in that selfish way. You behave in a way of ignorance. You behave in a way that you don't really care about the other person. You're not sensitive enough. And again, the purpose why God shows you, so you'll be able to work on it, so you'll be able to increase your ability to love, to increase your ability to care and to be sensitive and to be less and less selfish. And that's really the purpose, because again, as we said, the whole purpose of life is to learn how to be less selfish, and not just to be less selfish, even more than that, to actually take the selfishness and transform it into caring and sharing. So that's basically what we learned last time. Now we're continuing, we're jumping to verse number 5. So he says here, in this great article called Gift of the Bible, on verse 5 he says, Rabbi Ashlag asked, why was the Torah given on Mount Sinai to the nation of Israel? If the whole message of the Torah is the message of love, is to teach us how to love, beautiful, let's teach it to the entire world. So on Mount Sinai, when God invited the people of Israel, come, I want to give you the gift called the Torah. Rabbi Ashlag is asking the question, why God is not inviting all the nations of the world to come and receive that great message called Torah? Why not? If it's so good, right? That's the question. And Rabbi Ashlag asked, is that because God prefers the people of Israel more than other nations? Rabbi Ashlag says, of course not. Don't even think like that. Don't even imagine to think like that. God is not preferring one person over the other or one nation over the other, because God is the force of love. God is the force of unconditional love. It means that he cannot prefer someone more than someone else, because his love is unconditional and all the time and for everyone. So it says, Rabbi Ashley says, that the sages already thousands of years ago asking the same question. And it says in the ancient writings of the Kabbalists, thousands of years ago, it says that actually, before God gave the Torah to the people of Israel on Mount Sinai, God actually offered the Torah to every nation of the world. There were, and still there are, 70 basic nations in the world. And God actually offered it to each and every one of them, but they refused to accept it. They refused to receive it. And the question we should ask, why? If God is coming to you, coming to a certain nation, and tell them, I want to give you a gift. It's called the Torah. Right? Why are you refusing? It's a gift from God. Right? If we understand in a deeper understanding what is the Torah, we can understand it. The message of the Torah, the same way that people might, you know, can register to a gym, right, to exercise, and but eventually many people, even though they register, they're paying, but they're not going. They would like to go to the gym, but they're tired, and they don't feel like, and they're lazy, right? So eventually, not going to the gym. Even though we want to practice constantly loving that human being, we don't want to practice constantly letting go of the ego. But this is very hard. It's actually, according to Kabbalah, the hardest thing to do in the world. And that's why when the different nations of the world ask God, God, what is this Torah that you want to give us? What's in it? Well, what's it? Is it all about? And God told them, it's all about exercising, being less and less selfish, and more caring for the world. To such a level that you're actually pushing yourself to put what you want a little bit aside and think first of all what the other person needs. First of all what the world needs. Most of the world, it's very hard for them to live that way of life. But eventually that's the goal of humanity. That's how we all supposed to achieve to that level of reality, that level of consciousness. Back then, when God wanted to give the Torah to the different nations of the world, you know, today most of the world is, you know, less primitive and more and more developed. But imagine 3,300 years ago, most of the world were like, you know, the ancient Egyptians and the ancient Romans. They were people that were, the focus of their life is to conquer, is to control, is to kill if needed, it's to steal if needed. That's how the world lived. Today the world is started to move forward, hopefully, you know. But back then, when God told them, I want you to receive the Torah and start to practice caring for others and caring for the world, the people said, God, it's too much for us. It's too big for us. We can't handle it. We're not there. We're not there even to start that kind of spiritual journey. And, you know, I'm continuing on number 5. So God is, Rabbi Ashlag asks, why is the people of Israel called the chosen nation? If God actually offered the Torah to every nation of the world, but they actually refused, so God said to the people of Israel, you know, everyone is refusing. No one wants to receive this Torah that I want to give them. Please accept it for me. Please, at least you'll be the one to actually say, okay, we'll take this message called the Torah. So it's not really that God chose the people of Israel, it's just no one else wanted it. So why is it that the people of Israel called the chosen nation? What does it mean exactly? You see that suddenly as we're starting to learn Rabbi Ashlag, we start to see that there is the deeper understanding about the Torah and about the spiritual journey that we never understood. And without learning from the writings of Rabbi Ashlag, we would think that the Torah is like, you know, what we understood so far. Suddenly we realize that there's deeper levels of what's the message of God to the world. And that's why it's so important to learn these articles. And Rabbi Ashlag says, let's continue a little bit more on verse 6, and then we'll finish for today. Rabbi Ashlag says on verse 6, if we understand in a deeper way what the Torah is all about, and what the precepts of the Torah are all about, we understand that this is the purpose of all life, the purpose of all creation. And then we'll understand everything. And Rabbi Ashlag says, the first thing we should know in order to understand life, in order to understand our life, in order to understand God, in order to understand the purpose of life, in order to understand what Kabbalah is all about, the first thing a person should accept upon themselves, Rabbi Ashlag says, is that there is nothing happening in the world without a purpose. Everything that's happening in the world, everything that's happening in your life, there is a reason why it's happening. And there is a thought behind it. And God thought and think about everything that is happening from a point of view that that thing that I'm going through right now, maybe I don't understand why I'm going through it, but it will help me to achieve my perfection. It will help me to achieve the purpose of life. Every little thing or every big thing that I'm going through, me or the entire world. And the first thing in order to understand true spirituality is to understand that nothing happening in the world without a thought behind it. And it's a thought of God. And the thought of God is only good. Because God is only good. And everything that God is doing is only for the greatest good of each and every one of us and all of us collectively. And that's why, in order to really understand God and understand the purpose of life, we need to understand that everything that's happening to me, it's because God wanted it to happen, to help me to grow to my next level of spirituality. And by understanding it, we should not have any more doubts about God. God, why are you doing that? Why, God, why don't help me what I need you? Once we understand it deeply, what we just learned, we should push away doubts about God and we start to understand that everything that's happening to me, it's helping me and I need to accept it as a lesson for me to grow. And by doing that, I'm not anymore involved with doubting God and be angry about God or about life and be a victim and blaming life and blaming the other person, blaming God. It's all an opportunity for me. That's the first thing to understand and to accept if we want to really be successful in the game of life. Let's continue just a little bit more. You know what? We'll continue next time. So, it was a pleasure. Today was class number 2. If you have friends that still would like to register this week, it's the last opportunity to register for this course. Until next time, we'll all start it again. Again, as I mentioned, this course is free. There is no any fee, any commitment. The only commitment is for yourself to learn these lessons so you can enjoy the message of God to your life, that it's an international message for every human being in the world that wants to really start to do the spiritual work in a deep way. So to achieve real success, to achieve true fulfillment, true happiness in life. So that's why I encourage and recommend everyone, invite your friends, invite your family, allow them to be part. It's amazing. It's encouraging, it's empowering, and thank you for joining. And I really recommend, make sure that every class you actually listen to it, and you're also reading the text that I'm sending you, the actual original text of Rabbi Ashlag, learning it. You'll see, if you take it seriously, if you do the effort to study and to practice these teachings, you will see and feel the blessing and the love of God being revealed in your life in a more realistic way, and you'll be able to feel how you can allow the blessings of God to manifest in your life and to see the blessing of God manifested in every area of your life more and more and more, because that's our purpose. We all want to be happy. We all want to be joyful, and that's what God wants for us. And we just need to learn how to receive all the blessings that God wants to give us. So thank you and good luck. and blessings to all.